Hi, this is Teacher Jennifer from U.S. Citizenship Podcast. In December 2017, USCIS announced that we can now submit our N-400 application for naturalization online. So I'd like to show you how to create an account. Let's get started. We're on the USCIS.gov main page. I'm clicking the banner about the new N-400. We're at the N-400 page, and we have information about submitting the N-400. I'm going to the button on the right-hand side, and I'm scrolling past the other buttons that talk about the other forms that you can submit online. I'm going to the N-400 page, or clicking the N-400 button, and this is going to take us to a newer URL. My account .uscis.dhs.gov. Don't worry, we're still with the Department of Homeland Security. We're going to scroll to the bottom and we're going to create a new account. So we're creating the account, and what they would like us to do is put in our email. So here's my email, Long May She Wave. It was a Tumblr that was dedicated to the U.S. flag. I'm signing up, and now I'm going to my email box, and I see that I have an email that says, please click this URL that has a confirmation token. So I'm going to this account, or this new website. And it's basically going to have information for me to put in a password. What do I need in the password? I have to have at least one upper case letter, one lower case letter, one number, and a special character. And some people like to show their email, their passwords, but let's see if I can get in. And so now it's making sure that I have this is one time prep. Every time I log in, do you want to have you will be given a one time password. How would you like to receive it? Would you like to get it through email, or would you like to get it through mobile? I frequently prefer getting my things through email. I'm going to submit it again. And now it's going to give me a special email for this time that I'm getting in here. Why are they doing this? They want to make sure that people have that your account and your personal information remain secure. So I'm going back to my email. And hopefully I have a new password that I can use only one time. So whenever you go to your accounts, you gotta make sure that you do have access to your email. Let's check it again. Oops. Yeah, there it is. My secure one-time password notification. Here it is right here. This is the number. I'm simply gonna copy that. And I am going to, here it is. I'm going to put it in, and it's submitted. And now it's going to take me to a new screen. Again, it's going to ask me some security questions. So here I am going to have a whole bunch of security questions. Question one, what was the last name of my favorite childhood teacher? I can type in the response. The city and town where I met my spouse. Well, I'm not married, so that's not going to be a good one for me. And what was the name of the company for my first paid job? Here are some other passwords, security questions. What was the first team sport you played? What is the first city that you visited without your parents? And what city or town were you in when you saw the ocean for the first time? What is the first name and the last name of your oldest cousin? Who was your childhood hero? In what city or town were you in January 1st, 2000? What was the name of your second pet? What is the name of the first school you attended? Where was your wedding reception held? When was your youngest sibling born? What is the country of your ultimate dream vacation? What was the last name of your first sports coach? What was the first thing you learned to cook? What was the name of the company in which you got your first promotion? What was the make and model of your first car? What is the first name and the last name of your favorite childhood friend? In what city did you first visit a museum? What was your favorite toy when you were a child? Who is a famous deceased person who would l you like to have met? What is your father's mother's maiden name? What type of work did you do in your first job? So many questions. Do you have to answer them all? No, you don't have to answer them all. Simply type in the one, pick three that's going to be the most appropriate for you, and the names that you would basically remember. I'm not married, like I said, so I'm going to first team sport. My family plays football, so that's what I'm going to type. Other people would put in soccer and the company of your first paid job. Oh my gosh, I can't even remember that. That was so long ago. And so there's more questions. Let's see if I could get one. First one, first team, first sport team. Let me see. What was the first visit place I visited without my parents? San Francisco. Oh dear, I didn't type that anywhere closely. Fran. How silly of me. San Francisco. And let's see. Let me see another question. Who is your childhood hero? Well, my childhood hero, I have to say, is the wonderful spouse of FDR, Eleanor Roosevelt. Eleanor Roosevelt. Again, there's so many more questions that you could answer. I just picked the easiest ones for myself. I submitted these. Again, they're using them for security to make sure that you're really the person that you say you are. If there's any question identifying who you are, they can come back and check this. Am I a customer? Am I going to be submitting an application, or am I an attorney? Well, I'm going to be a customer. Sometimes I help my students with their applications, but right now I'm trying to demonstrate it for people, and I'm submitting that. And now it's basically creating the account. And once that's created, I will show where you go from here. So this is welcome to your USCIS account. We can track a case that we already have. We could file a form. We could enter a representative passcode if somebody's helping you, or you can verify your identity. So I'm going to be stopping the video now, and we're going to come back and we're going to file a form.